to do. Chapter number 1, class 8, history, how, when, and where. How important are dates in the history? So, dates are the most important thing in the history. So, dates tells when the king was born, when he dies, when he fought the battle, when he won the battle, when his child born, like this. There were many battles fought against this. So, I have collected more information on dates. So, but I will tell you what I have written on this. So, I have written, there was a time when historians were fascinated with dates. There were heated debates about the dates. About the dates on which rulers were crowded or battles were fought. History is certain about the changes that occur over the time. It is about finding out how things were in past and how things have changed. As soon as we compare past with the present, we refer to the time we talk of after and before. Second point, all such historians question refer us back to the notion of time. But time does not have to be always preciously dated in terms of a particular year or a month. Third, sometimes it is actually incorrect to fix precious date to process that happen over a period of time. So it is easy to remember the thing that has happened on the particular date, like Earth Day. When it is, we have given the particular date. It is on 22 March. So we remember it, 22 March ko hai Earth Day. So we will remember. So we give the particular date to the venue or that thing had happened. So next question we will do. So second question, why do we continue to associate history with a string of date? So basically with association has a reason. Okay. So it is more similar to the last question. So it basically tells the history was an account of battles and big events, and history was wrote by telling us that when king got married, when he has a child, when he was crowned, like these. And specific dates can be determined, like I have given you the example of Earth Day. We remember it on which date it is? 22 March. So like this we remember. Okay, we don't remember like this Earth Day is in March. We have given the specific date for it. So like this we will start writing. Its answer starts like we can make first point. This association has a reason. Second, there was a time when history was an account of battle and big events. Third, it was about rulers and their policies. Fourth is, historians wrote about the year and a king. Thank you. Yeah, so I have tell you. Yeah, a king was crowned. The year he married. Okay, so like this, the year he married, he had a child. Many more. You will not like this. We will like this. I'm just explaining to you. Next you can write the year he fought a particular battle. For the year he died. Year he died. Okay. And the year the next ruler succeed to the throne. Like this. So next ruler succeed to the throne. Fifth point and the last point. For events such as these, specific date can be determined. And in history, such as these debates about dates continue to be important. So, our third question, how did James Mill view India? So, I am dictating this and explaining you by dictating. You can write these points. First, James Mill, Scott, I am writing the keywords. James Mill, a Scottish economist and political philosopher. James Mill, a Scottish economist and political philosopher, published a massive 3-volume work, A History of British India. That was the first point. And I can write this point also. Massive 3-volume. Okay. Our second point is, I am writing only the keywords and dictating the whole point. Okay, second point, Mill thought that all Asian society were at the lower level of civilization. Then Europe. According to him, before the British came to India, Hindu and Muslim despot ruled the country. Third point, religious and intolerance. Religious intolerance, caste taboos, and superstitious practice dominated social life. Fourth, he left the British rule. Could civilize India? To do this, it was necessary to introduce European manners, institution and laws in the India. So many there are many things in this. So I will repeat whole of this. I have written the key points and I am dictating again the answer of this question. First, James Mill, a Scottish economist and political philosopher, published a massive 3-volume work, A History of British India. It could be in the commas. Second, Mill thought that all Asian society were at a lower level of civilization than Europe. According to him, before the British came to India, Hindu and Muslim despots ruled the country. Third, religious intolerance, caste taboos and superstitious practices dominated social life. Fourth, he left that British rule could civilize India to do this, it was necessary to introduce European manner, art, institution and laws in India. So next question. So historians have divided India into ancient, medieval, modern period. Even this periodization has some problem. What are the problems? So I am dictating you the answer. I have made the flowchart for you. Moving away from the British clarification, historians have usually divided India history into ancient, medieval, and modern. This division too has its problem. It is a periodization that is borrowed from the West, where the modern period was associated with the growth of all the forms of modernity, science, reason, democracy, liberty and equality. Medieval was the term used to describe the society where these features of modern society did not exist. It is not there in the society. Modern society did not exist. Under British rule, people did not have equality. The British do not have the equality. The people under the British, okay? I repeat the point. Under British rule, people did not have equality, freedom or liberty. Nor it was the period of economic growth and progress of the country. So next question. So my next question was, what is colonization? The change that British rule brought about in values and tasks, custom and practices of India when the subjection of one country and another lead to these kind of political, economic, social and cultural changes. We refer to the process of colonization. So let's move to next question.